Saturn desert. I heard there was a temple to Osiris there. Long forgotten and not mentioned in ancient records.
Hey, welcome back, lads. So we have a new Zombies map coming to Vanguard in Season 2, which is the first real DLC for this game, but there is a lot of confusion about what exactly this is and how it will work. So let's go over everything that we know and everything that we've heard so far, and one thing is kind of clear that this is not going to be a regular round-based Zombies map or experience, anything like that, which is actually what people want. Instead, it's going to be kind of like another thing just like Da and Fang. Now, on a side note, I've woken up with the most painful sore throat in the world, so if I sound like in pain and suffering, that is why. I thought I was getting better, but no. Anyways, we know that Vanguard Zombies is headed to Egypt in the next map, and it's going to be the main area or hub, just like what Stalingrad is in Daranfang. We believe that this is actually the multiplayer map Desert Siege, and some other details have been leaked out recently about the map, like the codename is Scorpion, which doesn't really tell us much, but it's cool nevertheless. And the other locations include the multiplayer map Oasis, something simply called Halls, like a hallway, I guess. And another location, which has also been confirmed officially, is the Dark Aether Dimension itself, which is going to be really cool to see that in-game. Like, we are literally going to hell. Remember that the Dark Aether here in Vanguard is different to what we saw in Cold War. This time it's more red and hellish, and I think it will have a kind of otherworldly vibe to it, kind of like the, what's it called, the crazy place in Black Ops 2 Zombies Origins, where it kind of feels like an underworld. It will be like that. Treyarch say that the Dark Aether location in Vanguard is completely original, so they've developed it specifically for zombies, which is nice to hear. You know, it's not just a multiplayer map or a campaign mission being reused, it is original. So yeah, just like Da and Fang, this map has the starting or hub location, and then three other locations that you teleport to while you do the objectives. So thinking about that, I do wonder how different is this actually going to make the game feel? You know, like in classic zombies where different round-based maps have different sizes, different difficulties, simplicities. So different maps offer different things, like different experiences. But since just how Vanguard Zombies works with the hub and the objectives, I wonder, is it even gonna feel that different? Is it gonna play any different to Da and Fang? Now, before my voice box completely dies out here, I'll leave you with the Intel radios that are setting up the events and backstory for this map, like the German operation going on here, and the temple to Osiris, the Egyptian god of death, and I think that is maybe what Oasis is supposed to be representing. So yeah, I look forward to this.
And preparations atop the Hotel Royale will ensure that all of Paris will soon experience a very different sort of nightlife. Be advised that another area of operations is underway. You may hear radio traffic from our unit in the eastern desert of Egypt. Theirs is a mission vital to protecting our most valuable ally, Herr Cortifex. Requests from this task force get top priority.
It's the expedition that recovered the scepter. All I know is it was found in Egypt's eastern desert. Far from the great cities of antiquity. I heard there was a temple to Osiris there, long forgotten and not mentioned in ancient records.